A diagnosis of diabetes shocks the life of not only the patient, but the entire family, and it can happen to anyone at any age. Today is Diabetes Alert Day, a day intended to be a wake-up call for everyone to understand their risk. And to help us do that, we've asked Dr. Vishal Bhatia, endocrinologist with Ascension St. Vincent Evansville, to join us this afternoon. Dr. Bhatia, thank you so much for joining us. Describe what diabetes is and how prevalent is it in our community?
Well, thanks for inviting me, and it's my pleasure to talk to you. Diabetes is a condition which is impacting millions of lives all over the world, especially in the U.S., here in Midwest. Diabetes is a condition in which our body is not able to handle blood sugars or blood glucose in a way it should be doing. We all need sugar to survive. And in this condition, our body loses the capacity to handle that sugar. And that sugar level in the blood, it goes up. It reduces our immunity. It impacts our different organs, impacts our kidneys, eyes, blood vessel, heart, putting us at a risk of complications from all these organs. Now, so there's an imbalance in the body of handling the blood sugars.
Okay. Now, I understand there's type 1 diabetes and type 2. What is the difference between them? One's hereditary, one's dietary. Is that correct?
In a broad sense, you can do that. But, you know, at the surface level, you can say that it's type 1 is genetic and the other one is dietary. But there are genetics at play in both the kinds of diabetes. In type 1 diabetes, our body is making some antibodies against pancreas. Now, pancreas is the organ in the body that is responsible for making insulin. Insulin is needed to handle blood sugars. So these antibodies are genetically linked, programmed in our body, and we are born with those antibodies. And those antibodies can start to manifest at any age, usually in a young age. But, you know, I have seen a type 1 diabetic as old as 94 years at the time of diagnosis.
Is that right?
So these these antibodies, they make your pancreas lose its capacity to make insulin, and you make no insulin or very less insulin and become diabetic, needing insulin all your life. While in type 2, we do have some defect in pancreas as far as the insulin production is concerned, but because of our diet and our lifestyle, we add the added insult to it. We induce insulin resistance. So genetics plus our lifestyle and dietary things, they lead to diabetes, blood sugar imbalance, which is type 2 diabetes. So we can give pills in those cases and may need insulin in many of those cases too.
Well, what advice do you have for folks to, I guess my question is it preventable? And it sounds like type 1, maybe not so much so, but type 2, can you prevent the onset of type 2 diabetes, and how do we do that?
We can certainly, we cannot defeat our genetics. If we are born with a tendency to become diabetic, as you have correctly said, type 1 diabetes, usually we cannot prevent it. We can be aware if our parents had it, if our grandparents had it, siblings have it. We can check on the routine basis to see if we are having type 1 diabetes. But in type 2 diabetes, certainly we can do a few things. We can follow a healthy lifestyle. We can keep our body weight in check. And in a way, we can try to keep our insulin levels resistance down. That is by following healthy lifestyle, exercise, diet, quitting smoking, limiting alcohol intake. So we can do a few things to really help our body and help ourselves as far as type 2 diabetes is concerned.
So basically, eat well, exercise, a healthy lifestyle is the best way. I wish we had more time because there are so many questions to ask, because this seems to be a growing problem because of much of our lifestyle. If we're sedentary anymore. But unfortunately, we've run out of time, so hopefully we can have you again another time, Dr. Vishal Bhatia, St. Vincent Ascension, to talk a little bit about diabetes. Thank you so much for your time today, sir.
Thank you very much. Thanks for inviting me. Mm-hmm.